It's an online learning destination and MOOC provider offering high quality courses from world's best universities and institutions to learners like you. We have with us Mr. Amit Goyal, Country Head EDX. Dear students, Mr. Amit heads India Business for EDX, which is not-for-profit organization and have a mission to provide free online access to high quality education for everyone. He holds a MBA from Oxford Brookes University. He has managed various executive roles in building million-dollar telco and edtech product across UK, Europe and India. Sir is a firm believer of frugal innovation, and his profile includes projects that attained significant limelight and disrupted the market. While heading the education solution business for Samsung India, he launched various education solutions including tablet MBA, which are currently used by major test prep companies and private universities in India. Sir is also credited for launching the cheapest tablet PC of the world, Akash, you must be knowing about it, for Ministry of HRD, Government of India. I welcome you to our dais, sir. We're looking forward to learn about advanced courses offered by EDX and how it can benefit us in our career. I request you to please start the session.
Good morning, everyone. So all charged up? Did you had your morning session? Oh, great. And thank you for such a warm introduction. You have pretty much spoken everything that I wanted to cover. As she rightly said, I'm an edtech guy. I did my graduation from India and then my post-graduation from abroad. And I realized the stark difference in quality of education, right? The way we learn here and the way we learn abroad, there was a lot of difference. But thankfully to private institutes, the mission-driven organizations, this gap has really reduced. The kind of education that you get here is no less than what you study at Oxford, MIT or Harvard, right? Thanks to stalwarts like Mr. Garg here, who is trying his level best to accommodate that your learners are able to get the best-in-class quality education. So I'll quickly tell you about edX in a while, but before that, let's make this session interactive. So I also want to know, so you just heard my introduction. I also want to know a bit more about you. Why did you choose this program? Why MBA? What are the future plans that you have? Anyone could volunteer, please? You perhaps? Yes? What do you wish to do after your MBA?
Sir, I would love to do a great job and study further as well.
Okay. Yes. Okay, so a job, anyone with a entrepreneurial background who wants to start their own startup or a business, you there? Yes, what do you want to do?
Actually, I'm not clear with what I want to do, but yes, I want to become an entrepreneur.
Okay, that's good. Anyone wants to join family business, contribute their, or I think a good job is what most of us are looking for. So I think our first step is to have some really good work experience and then go on and look at what we want and what we don't want. So, okay. Now, you're all MBA students, right? Did you took your CAT exam? Were you aspiring for IIMs? Couldn't get through? But this is a great enough option, right? Now, tell me, why do we all fancy IIM so much? I mean, it's such a crazy rat race there. Why do you want to go to IIM? What's the one thing which you get at IIM? What is your key incentive to look for an opportunity at IIM? Placements, right? A higher job package? Something like this? When such news comes out, huh? Right, but I think eventually it leads to the package. Ki Sharma ji ke bete ko kitne paise mil rahe hain. Right? So, and if we could get a bit more candid, if you be a bit more honest with me, right now do you feel you will be able to get such kind of packages here? Okay. No, I actually wanted to hear it. Why? Because there's a story which I'm going to tell you. Right? I find this social experiment pretty amusing. So, a group of scientists were trying to study human behavior. Monkeys, I mean, we have all evolved from there. So what they did was, they put five monkeys in a cage. And when they put five monkeys, as you can see, they placed a ladder there. On the top of the ladder, they put some bananas. Now, as soon as you put monkeys in a cage, what will they do? They'll climb up and grab the bananas. And this is what the poor monkey did. His fault was he wanted to go get the bananas. As soon as he started doing it, his remaining friends were sprinkled with ice cold water. They had no idea why it happened to them. Unka friend gaya tha banana khane, wo to niche aaram se baithe the. Unke upar they put ice cold water. Now the second monkey climbed up the ladder and the same thing happened. Their friends were splashed with ice cold water. Do teen baar hua and then they got to know ki agar koi bhi friend upar gaya, he touched the bananas, to rest of us are going to get bashed. So now nobody is going to climb up the ladder and trying to eat the bananas because everybody is bashing them. What they did was, they put one monkey out of the cage and put a new monkey. Now this new monkey doesn't know anything. What will he do as soon as he enters into the cage? What will he do? He'll try and grab the bananas. As soon as he started climbing up the ladder, before even reaching there, his friends pulled him down and they bashed him red and black. And this new guy has no idea. क्योंकि उसने तो पानी गिरते हुए नहीं देखा. He doesn't know why is this happening to him. But he knows कि ठीक है, this is the culture. ऐसा हो रहा है. Then they put in another monkey. They replace second monkey and put in a new one. Second monkey will also going to do the same thing. But this time something interesting happened. The first monkey who was recently bashed up, he also joined up the gang in bashing the second monkey. And he has no idea why is he beating that monkey. He has not seen the water getting splashed. And gradually all the monkeys were replaced. Nobody is going to climb up the ladder and grab those bananas. I see a lot of monkeys here, right? So when you say that you won't be able to get this kind of package, I don't really agree with you because you don't really know what's in the hand. Just getting a brand name like IIM or IIT doesn't mean that you won't be able to get this kind of package. A lot of students who are not able to make to those Ivy Leagues, they get much, much better packages than them. So you really need to be opportunist. You really need to make use of the current time that you have at hand and make your way forward. And I've seen this very closely. I've been into education technology domain for all my career. And I've seen this happening. People who don't really go to Ivy League universities, eventually they end up making a lot of money than those who went there. All they need to do is stay active and make use of opportunities that come their way. If you can't go there, that doesn't mean you won't be able to get the same quality of education. I'll give you some more background about it. So the first thing wherein you said, when I interacted with you, a lot of you didn't really know what to do in your life, right? Somebody wanted to be an entrepreneur, somebody wanted to have a good job, have future study, further study, and then perhaps join the family business. I think setting the right vision is most important. Right, so when we say that guys who made at IITs and IIMs, they were crazy, it's not that. Their vision was confined to that. They know ki this is my destiny, I have to go and get it. Similarly, you guys also need to set up your vision right now. Right now, you have enough resources to really make up what you want to do in your life. Nobody is holding you back. You have access to internet, you have access to so many resources, you have access to so many inspirational studies out there. You can absolutely figure out what you want to do in your life. Or right now, I would say when I was a student of your age, I also didn't know what to do in my life. But what I did know is what I don't want to do in my life. I knew I was good at making products, but I was horrible at coding. So I said, I don't want to do coding. Similarly for you guys, a good way to start finding out what you don't want to is what you want to do in your life is to figure out what you don't want to do in your life. Narrow down your search criteria, set the vision. And if you think you don't have what it takes to achieve what you want, you need to either modify your dream or magnify your skills. This place is offering you the same opportunity. You can magnify your skills while you're working. You also need to have the right attitude for success, right? If you just feel that, theek hai, constantly chal raha hai, 10th kar li, 12th kar li, MBA kar li, uske baad kuch dekhenge, jo campus ne job lagwa di, it wouldn't really work that way. You are youth, right? You have everything at your hand. all you need is the right attitude for success. And people say, yeah, this guy just got lucky. Uska 1 crore ka package lag gaya. Theek hai? He wasn't lucky. Luck is, I mean, it, as it rightly says, is what you make of things when life, of what life throws at you. If life gives you lemon, you make lemonade. Whatever opportunities that you get, you have to make good use of it. For how many of you, failure is not an option? Anyone? Is there anyone here for whom failure is an option? Yes or no? For you? Oh, okay. That's good to know. Yes. This is what I want to hear. Because failure is always an option. Failure teaches you so many things. When I completed my MBA, I was beaming with a spirit to change the world. I saw that there is something which India desperately needs. I started my own e-learning company in UK. It was doing pretty well there. But then I decided to expand it. One thing or another didn't work out. Perhaps the market wasn't ready. Perhaps I wasn't too qualified. And I eventually wasted all my earnings, all my savings, and it all went down from there. But that taught me a lot. I know what Indian consumers would want, where my product failed, what were the flaws, why wasn't I able to market this properly. So failure has taught me a lot of things. And I think gradually, after 7 years, when Harvard University was interviewing me, they asked me, why should we give you this role? And I told them, because I am the only guy who knows exactly what not to do. You won't get this experience anywhere else. So I think failure will teach you a lot of things, but you don't really have to wait for a failure to acquire that kind of knowledge. You need to have a firm belief in you. When I asked you, would you be able to get this kind of package? You said, no, I just don't agree with it, right? Doesn't matter if you go to IITs or IIMs, whatever institute you are in, your peers care for you. Your faculty, your management, they take care of you. All you need is to have some self-belief. I was shattered when I couldn't get into IIT, but I made sure at that time that I make my way to Oxford. I'm an Oxford alumni. It wasn't easy, but I made my way up. And I think the same goes for you. You need to have self-belief in yourself. Your peers have belief in you. Your management, your institute, everything has belief in you. All you need to do is just connect the dots. Look at the things which are around you. And, you know, we live in a very, very complex VUCA world, as we say there. I think, Raman, we also discussed this terminology once in our last meeting, perhaps. So, tomorrow, when you graduate, you'll get into a really, really complex world. Is there anyone who wants to join their family business here? Anyone? That's good. You'll make your own business, right? So as I was saying, the world is very, very VUCA. So it says it's very volatile. For example, how many of you use Uber here? Almost everyone. See, do you remember the days when you have to hackle with the auto wala ki bhaiya meter se chalo? Or coming out of the station and, you know, staying on the mercy of those kali pili taxi wala, and he'll say ki theek hai, I'll charge whatever I want. That trend has changed. Right? Remember the days when you have to go and line up at the railway station just to get your tickets booked. Now, if somebody says ki ticket book karani hai, would you think to go to a railway station or go to an airline booking counter? You'll just do it online. Right? Similarly, the change is happening everywhere. Right? Hotels have been clearly changed. The hotel industry has been revolutionized upside down by Airbnb. You have the local guy, Oyo rooms here. So everybody can just own a hotel there. The definition of the businesses is changing. It's getting more complex. And that's why you need to stay updated and relevant to combat that VUCA world. And how would you do that? You would need to create your own development plan. So what all courses are we taking here? MBA marketing here? MBA finance? Okay. Are you getting your skills? Who's MBA finance? Are you familiar with R? Not return, R, language. See, tomorrow when you go out looking for jobs, the employer just won't say, "Theek hai, your MBA finance, I'll hire you." Because the requirements have changed. They're sitting on a large chunk of data. For example, if I'm Flipkart, I know I have 1 million transactions happening on my portal every day. I just don't want a fancy MBA finance guy to just come and make decisions. I want them to make data-driven decisions. I want them to look at the analytics of the transaction. Ki is area mein is level ki transactions ho rahi hain. For example, if I know ki on a remote area of India, if the transaction size is less than 500 rupees, then there is no point that I pitch a 10,000 rupees product there. So this is what they expect from guys like you. MBA marketing here? Are you using Google Analytics? They're teaching it to you here? You are acquiring it by yourself. So marketing itself is not sufficient. Tomorrow when you have to go and look out for jobs, especially in the marketing domain, they don't need a newbie or an unexperienced person to come and tell them that this is how you should market. Sorry, advertisement aise achhi lagegi, ab isme Kareena Kapoor lagwa lo. It won't work that way, right? The world is changing. It's a digital world that we are living in today. They want you to have a particular expertise. For an MBA marketing, they want you to have knowledge of digital marketing. For MBA finance, the employers would want you to have a specialization in data analytics or data-driven business decisions. Similarly, for HR, they would also want you to have knowledge about digital product management, digital leadership, digital transformations, digital methods to save cost. So a specialization is required. And how would you do that? I'll just tell you, this is something that we do at edX. So the learning doesn't necessarily has to happen on campus. It could happen anywhere outside the campus, while on your way here, out of your way here, whatever you do, learning should never stop. And in order to do that, now I come to a main service. So edX, as was mentioned in our introduction, is a joint venture of MIT and Harvard University. And there's a small history behind it. So there was a professor at MIT, and he was really good at his work. He had headed the Department of Computer Science there for 25 years. MIT is the number one engineering college of the world, just FYI. If you talk about the top 400 colleges of the world, then only one IIT comes around 283 or 284. The rest of them, they can't even make it to that list. Now this professor decided that, hey, I'm a teacher at MIT, and my course is so great, but still, MIT only has very limited access. Every year, we can't take more than 90 students. So on one hand, we have the best quality of education. On the other hand, our doors are closed for almost the entire world. We need to do something. So he decided to put his course online. Within 1 month, 155,000 students from all over the world, every country on this planet, they took his course. About 7,200 students passed the entire course. The assessment criteria was same, which he uses for his own campus work. Now, out of 150,000, 7,200 is still a lot. It's a very small number. But it would have taken that professor 80 years to teach that many number of students. And that's when Harvard and MIT got interested. They decided to join hands, first time in the history, and thus edX was born. It's a mission-driven company. The mission is to provide access to quality education to everyone on this planet, to students, to working professional, to anyone. Tomorrow, you can't really say that I can't get access to IIM, or I can't get Oxford access to Oxford. With this, the doors to all of those top universities are open for you. Today, edX is close to, the figure has reached over 12 million now, 1500 plus courses in anything that you may think of. Circuits and electronics, artificial intelligence, machine learning, data analytics, organization behavior, marketing, digital marketing, branding. Whatever comes to your mind, you would be able to find a course from one of the top university there. We have about 130 plus top universities of the world with us. That includes Oxford, Berkeley, Columbia, Harvard, MIT. In India, we partner with IIT Bombay, IIM Bangalore, Microsoft, Linux Academy, etc., etc. And they all offer their online courses. And the best part is, it is absolutely free because it's a mission-driven company. The mission is to provide you access to quality education. Nobody is charging you any money for it. The business model is, while the learning is free, they may charge a small fee for the certificate, which is optional. If you just want to go there and acquire knowledge, so think of it as an open classroom. You can go walk into an Oxford University class, take the entire course, sit through the exams, and be done with it. You don't have to pay anything. You will be learning from the same faculties. You will be acquiring the same skills as their students will acquire. All that is the flexibility at your own pace, while sitting in your garden, while going back to your home. You can take these courses online at your own pace and convenience without paying anything to anyone. Why don't I just give you a quick demo? Has anyone taken a course on edXs yet here? This really breaks my heart. Oh, you? Good. So I'll just give you a quick tour. Connected. Just bear with me for a minute. I'm just trying to connect to internet here. Koi aur internet connection option hai aapke paas? Just bear with us for 2 minutes. So who has completed a course on edX here? I saw some hands going up. Which course did you take? Wow. So she took the HTML course from the makers of HTML, World Wide Web. Did you manage to complete the course? Oh, okay. No, I mean, you should also try. There are so many MOOC platforms out there. Like edX is one of them. I mean, Coursera is there. There is Udemy. There is Udacity. There are so many learning platforms. Khan Academy, but that's more geared towards K-12, right? But for higher education, you have all these options. Now, unfortunately, education is pretty much commercial these days. So companies like Coursera or anyone else for that matter, they won't give you access to free education. They are paid. So you need to pay about, what, 3,500 rupees per month just to access your content. And then the certification fee is anyway extra. G. Okay, from your system. Okay. So this is edX. And as I was telling you, founded by MIT and Harvard, and we have all these institutes with us. Whatever you want to study, you will find everything right here. I think this is a mobile view, so that's why it's not coming very clearly over here. But whatever area of interest that you have, your MBAs, right? So we'll go to business and management. And we'll find a course that will interest you. Let's say I am Bangalore, operations management. You can see this is a course which is offered by IIM Bangalore. It's a free course. If you want a certificate, it costs you $150, which is optional. What will you learn? It tells you everything right here. He's the same professor who teaches at IIM Bangalore campus who will be teaching you this course here. And you can simply click on enroll now over here. Create an account. I already have one. I'll take this course on audit track. There you go. I can simply start this course here. So you can see it's a 6-week course, and all the weekly modules are here. It will give you knowledge to entire operations management. Each course will require you to study about 3 to 4 hours a week. And we go here. We'll start with first exercise. And it's all video driven. So what is the standard duration of a lecture that you have here? 50 minutes. And how much time does it take you to get bored? You lose your interest after 20 minutes, 30 minutes, 40 minutes. Okay. So at edX, we do neuroscience because we know that if we make you sit through a lecture or a video note for more than 10 minutes, we will lose your interest. So that's why it's a bite-sized learning platform. We'll watch a small video here.
So why do you need operations management for organizations like you?
You don't have to make notes while the professor is teaching you. The notes are right here, which you can download. There would be subtitles available as well in different languages.
Well, professor.
That will pop up.
Operations management is where the management has not been there.
And then you can download these videos as well. You can also take them while you're on go through your Android or iOS phone. And at the end of every course, there's a weekly assessment, which basically tests that whatever you have learned in that video, are you really able to apply that into practice or not? And that's how you gradually pass through a course. We have a progress monitor here, which is a report card of what you have done and what not. So you take a course, submit your answers, you print this report card and show to your teacher that this is your proof of completion. So I was just discussing it with Mr. Garg that what we should also think is to introduce some of these courses into your curriculum. So somebody who is doing, let's say, introduction to marketing, they should also acquire some knowledge about digital marketing. For your internal assessments, you should be able to take these courses online and get the same credits. So tomorrow, once you go out to employers, you would be able to say that, hey, I have this MBA marketing, but at the same time, I have this specialization as well. I'll show a bit about the specializations that we have. Do we have any BBAs here or all MBAs? Okay, so perhaps that ship has sailed now, but what we have done is we have just unbundled education. Wherein, we'll go to MicroMasters. So you see all these specializations which are here. Business Leadership by University of Queensland, Corporate Finance, Business Fundamentals, Brokerage Operations, Digital Product Management, etc., etc. Now, these programs are a bit intense. So I'll just come up to one that is... Okay, perhaps it's not here. Right, so let's say I randomly pick up robotics, if somebody is interested in robotics. Then we have put an online semester here, which is a part of a degree. So let's say tomorrow, or why don't I switch back to the presentation, I'll give you a better view there. How do I disconnect this? You just witnessed the courses, you just learned how to find a course of your choice and start taking it. And I just showed you the different features of the platform that you have there, which is very interactive, very active learning based. The best part is, it's a Facebook of learning experience there. When you're taking an online course from edX, at any given point of time, hundreds and thousands of students around the world would be taking the same course with you, which means you're sitting in a virtually global classroom. So today, if a professor is teaching you something, and you have a doubt somewhere, Do you really get up in front of the class and clear your doubts there? It doesn't really happen, right? Some of the students might do it. Some of the shy ones wouldn't really do it. But the best way to learn is to go and check with your peers. Ki yaar mujhe ye cheez nahi samajh mein aayi. Do you know ye kaise hoga? And that's how we learn today. The same thing is applied there as well. Whenever you're taking a course there, hundreds and thousands of people are taking the same course. So sitting in a virtual classroom, whatever your query is, whatever your problem is, like demonetization could have different meaning for India or for China or for West Indies. So share your experience. You have a Facebook of learning experience. You can chat with your peers there. You can post something onto the discussion forum. And we have seen that within 7 minutes, somebody from around the world who might be taking the same course as you would come back to you with a response. This is the kind of a certificate that you will get. Now, do you think this will look impressive in your profile? The Harvard logo could be any logo there. It could be IIT Bombay, IIM Bangalore, or Oxford University, any course. Now, these things are certainly going to make you more employable. And we have seen a lot of students who say that their lives have been changed because they just augmented what they were studying in college with these additional courses. So you don't really have to say that I won't be able to get that 1 crore package. Of course, you will be able to get that 1 crore rupees package and above. But you need to believe in yourself. You need to look at the options which are open around you. Start taking these courses, not just from edX, but there are so many learning portals out there. But just open your eyes and do more than what your coursework requires, because this is what the employers are looking out there. That makes you more employable. One such learner, he had absolutely no hope of a campus placement, was doing his BTech from a random college in Bangalore. I shouldn't be saying this, but I'm just being candid here. And he has no chance for a campus placement. In his final year, he took a couple of courses from edX platform, especially the Microsoft ones. Microsoft interviewed him. They skipped his technical round because they know that you have a proven source of expertise. We don't really have to go to the technical details. And they hired him. We have so many students whose life were changed with edX. So many learner stories around the world. What we see is those who complete an edX course, 43% of them, they report a career advancement. A lot of them boost it on LinkedIn profile. They share it on their resume. What I was telling you is MicroMasters. So what MIT and Harvard have done is they realize that education perhaps tomorrow is going to get unbundled. So you would be able to study one semester at Rdias, second semester at Oxford University, third at MIT, and get your global degree. And how we have done it is we have launched MicroMasters, which is, for example, they had a master's degree. So I'll give you an example here. A MicroMasters basically is a 6 months program that you do on edX, which is equivalent to one semester of a master's degree. It costs you about $1,000 for the certificate. If you don't want a certificate, this is absolutely free to learn. And this gives you credit. In India, we don't really use credit system, but how it works is, this is an example. For example, if somebody wants to make a career in supply chain management, right? Tell me a couple of industries wherein supply chain management is used. You're all MBAs here. Where? Be a bit louder, please. Any industry, for example, any manufacturing unit, correct. Any FMCG company, any e-commerce company, like Amazon, it started as a supply chain management company, as a logistics company. Gradually, they started selling all other stuff. So logistics is everywhere. That is becoming the backbone of the industry. If somebody wants to get the best degree in the world in logistics, it is offered by MIT, which is called Masters of Engineering in Logistics. It's a 1 year degree, which costs you about $70,000. Very difficult to get into. And what they have done is, they have put half of their degree online on edX in form of MicroMasters. And they call it MIT Supply Chain Management MicroMasters, which is absolutely free for all you guys out there. There are 40 such specialization. It has different courses, as you can see on your left, just like what you study on a semester. If you complete all these courses on a certificate track, then what you can do is you can apply to MIT. They will waive off your GMAT or GRE requirement, and you will be able to get an admission there just on the basis of an interview. And of course, if you clear it. But if you manage to get an admission there, you only have to pay 50% of your tuition fee. And instead of spending 1 year on campus, you only have to spend 6 months, and you will earn that master's degree. There are 40 such specializations out there right now, which includes a specialization in digital marketing, in data analytics, in robotics, artificial intelligence, machine learning, digital leadership. Any area wherein you want to make a career, I think you should really go out and try one of these expertise, one of these micro masters for yourself. Not only will it give you knowledge, it will give you the recognition by the employer, and of course the academic credits. So how does this sound? Like MBA finance from Rdias with business analytics from Columbia. MBA marketing from Rdias with digital marketing from Wharton. With this, do you think you'll be able to get that kind of package? You should be, because we have seen people getting it. In fact, we just started a pilot with a neighbor in Pakistan. It's a IT university in Karachi. And what they have done is, in their final semester, they just let a student choose one of the specialization, and they just take that course on edX. They come back to the classroom, discuss whatever problems that they have with their courses, any doubts that they may want to clear. For example, if you learn marketing from a global perspective, how will you use the same cases in India? So blended learning takes place. And when they complete it, the university grants them an integrated degree. And this is something that they get there. And we want to see the same thing happening here as well, because it is definitely going to make you much more knowledgeable and much more employable. These things didn't exist till a year ago, but now these things do exist. So I would want you to really exploit these opportunities which are out there. And the last part is, what about the employer credibility of these qualifications? So one part is, okay, we are offering online education. We are offering something on digital space. But will I get a job with these courses is a key question that always pops up. So edX is also trying to stitch the entire ecosystem back to back. So we work with a consortium of corporates. So you can see some names out there. They are way more than them. And what they do is they also use edX courses to train their existing workforce. For example, if you go to Genpact or, for example, Unilever, is recently taking our courses, a MicroMasters. So whenever a person joins Unilever, they have to go through certain edX courses. Now imagine tomorrow, MBA marketing guys here, if you go to them and tell them that, hey, I already have those courses for which you would have to pay me after your job, would you consider me for a job opportunity? And the answer would be yes. So you're stitching the entire ecosystem with corporates. They give due recognition to your credentials, to your profile, and they'll certainly give you a job opportunity. So that's all I have to offer today. I would say that you really need to focus on yourself. Formal education is going to give you a living, but self-education is going to give you a fortune. So I'm open to any questions that you might be having now. Please feel free, don't shy. I mean, ye mat sochna ki agar maine koi question pucha to kya meri beizzati hogi, anyone is going to make fun of me. I think it takes a lot of courage to ask a question, so please feel free. A lot of others could benefit from that as well. Yes, ma'am. Branding behavior, consumer behavior, marketing analytics. A lot of courses are there in marketing domain. You would be the best judge for that, I'd say. So just write people management. So what you can do is, and I think that's an excellent question, because a lot of people don't really know which course is best, right? What will it work out for them? So I think that's where you get the benefit. Whatever industry that you are in, whatever area of interest that you have, for example, you said HR. So just write HR there and see what all courses pop up. These courses are going to tell you that this is what you will learn once you complete this course. And you start taking this on free mode. If you like it, then continue it. If you don't like it, then switch to another one. So I would say from an educational perspective, everything is best out there. for every skill, there are ample job opportunities there, but you have to be the best in the league. Please.
I think to ask the right question is very important. When you say what is the best course or what is what would get me a best job, to ask the right question and then to set up a trap to get the answer is I think required. There are so many things on LinkedIn, debates, discussions, job posts. You can learn from that what is best, what is not best, what is in, what is out. And I think you need to ask the right question and then look at edX. That would make you realize, yes, this is what I want, and move on, and it will move you one step closer to your answer.
Yeah. So perhaps online research will give you ample information. You can always look at glass doors. You can also look at Burning Glass. So there is a website called Burning Glass. So if you go to Burning Glass and look at the skill set that you want, it will tell you what kind of skills are much needed in the market, what kind of skills have saturation. For example, I see that normal marketing would come to a saturation point. But if you talk about something in digital marketing and then again getting very very peculiar inside digital marketing, like Google Analytics per se, you will have much more, you know, paying scale for that, much more opportunities for it. So it's all about the skill gap which is there. For general skills, there are so many people out there. Like for MBA marketing, there would be so many MBA marketing applicants. But if somebody goes out to a company and say that, hey, I have this particular skill, then they obviously become much more employable. Any other question, guys? Yes, please. Mm-hmm. Right. You may or you might not be. So there are two kind of courses on edX. One is self-paced, which is open throughout the year. One is instructor-paced, which only have a specific start date and an end date. Let's say a course that I'm taking is on From Poverty to Prosperity by Oxford University. That only runs for about 2 months, and it runs about 3 to 4 times a year. So that is an instructor-paced course. Now, the method and the study material is everything is same, but while taking that course, the professor might be active in the discussion forum. So the answer to your question is maybe or may not be. But somebody from the course team would definitely reply to your query. So again, if that person is not reliable, then that's an online forum. For example, today if you post your views on Facebook, somebody would come up and counter question you. But then the third person could also come up and say, no, she is right. This is how you need to do it. So it's an open platform. If somebody from the course team might be wrong, then third person who's also a student could come back and say, no, this is how it's done. Because see, another thing is these are also massive online courses. So these professors who are teaching at these Ivy League universities, they can't really reply individually to, you know, millions of queries which are out there. So that's why the peer learning platform is there. Any other question, guys? All right, thank you so much for your time. I would really look forward to all of you to registering on this platform, right? If you have any query, please take help of your faculties or write a note on to edX. Thank you.
I'll just share a few words. Please do, as a vote of thanks. I'll tell you a little story. I was returning from Sonipat school. I was on LinkedIn, looking at, you know, what people have posted, and on my wall I found a post from Amit ji which said, any interested HR people, I am in Delhi, ping me and meet me. So I said, I am an HR people, let's go and meet him. So I replied. He said, where are you? I said, I am at Madhuban Chowk. He said, I am at Paschim Vihar, come and meet me. So I went and met him, and today is here. So this is the speed which you could, you know, You'll have to agree to work to. I connect to 50 people, 5 of them reply, 1 of them is here. So opportunity gets realized. You have to make your own opportunities. Nobody would, you know, I cannot look up to the sky and say, Amit ji, please come. This is rubbish, right? You'll have to have your own effort set it. And I'm really very grateful to Amit ji who's come here and spent time to speak to you. He's not promoting edX here. He's promoting you through edX. You need, as a student, edX today. You'll need it more tomorrow. Believe me, you'll need more tomorrow. So in that spirit, I hope that you'll all will look at edX today more seriously. And we as an institution,